Hi everyone, welcome back. Usually, the timeline scheduler views display the date and time information at its horizontal axis. But what happens if I want to display a huge number of days or months or weeks by extending the intervals on each of these timeline views? Say for example, imagine that I want to display 12 months in the timeline month view of the React scheduler, which is a complete year data, then simply displaying the usual date header row will not be clear enough when I scroll it beyond the current date range. I may not know to which one the current date range belongs to. In this case, I may need to add some additional header rows displaying the month name, year, and week numbers to clearly understand to which the date range it belongs to. To have good clarity, React Scheduler offers such header rows feature where you can display your own customized additional header rows on any of the timeline views. Now, in this video, let me show you briefly about header rows options in the React scheduler and how to customize it using built-in templates. The React scheduler offers 5 built-in header rows options, which are year, month, week, date, and hour. As I said before, you can define all these header rows in all the timeline views, and one such thing is the hour option is not applicable on the timeline month view. Okay, let me proceed with the example directly where I have added the React scheduler with simple JSON data. If you want to know the steps to add scheduler with simple JSON data, then you can look on to the YouTube card to listen my getting started video. Also, you can download the Getting Started sample from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Here, to make use of this header row feature, I need to import header rows directive and header row directive from Syncfusion EJ2 React Schedule package. And now, let me define the header rows directive tag, which accepts one or more header row directive tags. Here, I have defined 5 header row directive tags as I'm going to display 5 header row options like year, month, week, date, and hour. So, I need to set the option year for first header row directive, month for second header row directive, week for third header row directive, date for fourth header row directive, and hour for fifth header row directive. Also, make sure whether the timeline views and timeline month modules are imported and injected here, as these header row options are applicable only on timeline views. Look at the scheduler now. You can see 5 header rows displaying the values like year, month, week number, date, and time. This 5 header row representation is common in all the timeline views, which is timeline day, timeline week, and timeline work week. When I switch on to the timeline month view, you can find only 4 header rows, and each of these rows are displaying the values like year, month, week numbers, and date. Suppose if you want to customize the header row label appearance in React scheduler, then you can make use of a built-in template option. Now, let me proceed to show you how to customize the header rows to make it look like the same with 2 separate header rows displaying month, year, and week numbers and the date rows, which is common thing. Here, I'm going to work on the timeline month view, so let me remove the other views from the scheduler. Then, I have retained the month, date, and week header row options here and removed other header row options like year and hour. To customize the month header row, I need to define the template property with its relevant handler within the month header row option. Here, I have made a call to the template definition month template, which receives the complete date object as its argument. And within this month template method, I have created the spam element and also accessed the getMonthDetails method. Next, let me start to define the getMonthDetails method. Within this getMonthDetails method, I'm accessing the data value of the type cellTemplateArgs. To access this type, I need to import cellTemplateArgs from Syncfusion EJ2 React Schedule package. Now, I'm going to format the date value to display the date in year-month format. Here, to format the date, I have used the internationalization instance. So, let me define the instance of internationalization. And to access this internationalization library, I need to import it from Syncfusion EJ2 base package first. Now, when you look at the scheduler, you can see here the month header row displaying customized year month label. So, let me proceed to show you how to customize the week header row. Within this week header row option, I need to define the template property with its relevant handler. And here, I have made a call to the method weekTemplate, and within this weekTemplate method, I have defined the spam element and also accessed the getWeekDetails method. Now, let me define the method getWeekDetails, where I have accessed the data value of the type cellTemplateActs. And here, I am simply appending the text value week over here before the week number. To get the week number here, I have used this public method getWeekNumber. Now, to access this public method, I simply need to import this getWeekNumber method from Syncfusion EJ2 React Schedule package so that I will get the exact week number of the date I have passed. Okay, now I am done with customizing the week header row option. And now, you can see here, the word week has been appended before the week numbers, as well as you can see the month row with customized text. Also, you can notice that the scheduler displaying a single month here. So, if I want to display 12 months, that is a complete year, then I need to define the interval property with the value 12. And now, you can see the scheduler displaying a complete year date value. Okay. Let me summarize some of the important points which we have discussed in this video. We have seen about different header row options available in the React scheduler, as well as how to add those options in the timeline views. Also, how to customize the header rows with built-in template option and how to load a complete year data in the React scheduler. You can also get complete working of this sample from the downloadable example link which I have shared in the description part below. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you for watching this video.